Tomar este micrófono para mí es un privilegio que no merecía. A los loas, estaba perdido. And I came to the conclusion, llegué a la conclusión, that my problem started with something that really hurt me very much. I'm not talking about my mother, the way she rejected me. I'm not talking about the curse that I was into, not only myself or my family. Esa maldición donde se manifestaban los demonios y el diablo y castigaba a la familia. Punish my family. To watch my father doing things supernatural. Supernatural things that you never thought that a human being could do. Watch my mother being possessed. And when you begin to deal with these kinds of spirits, don't get scared the way I'm going to tell you this. No se ponga, no tenga miedo lo que voy a decirles. Yo lo vi. Mis hermanos lo vieron. I saw it, and my brother, all of us saw this. Our father never allowed us to either come close to all this manifestation that they used to do. But it's happened that my brother Koki and myself and Felix, always we used to have this curiosity. Los hermanos míos, Felix, Koki, siempre tenían, y Felix siempre tenían esa curiosidad. Y cuando estuvieron en el centro de la reunión, de pronto nosotros vimos something happened when we was out of the center, when they used to have all these things, all these manifestations. They brought this man. He was dying. Este hombre se estaba muriendo y lo trajeron. Habían allí muchos médiums que tenían la mano en la mesa. Tiraron a este señor en la mesa para que se muriese. They threw this guy right on the table to die. This was a long table. In one side, in the end, there was my father directing every spirit. In the other side, in the end, it was my mother. The reason, the success of the devil that really, really engañó. Really, this is what really happened. He counterfeited. We're looking, and it was an ugly, ugly sin. I mean, una escena, pero bien horrible. Mi papá, de una manera, cerró los ojos. De pronto, al otro lado, mi mamá está sintiendo lo que ese señor estaba sintiendo. Fíjense cómo se diablo. My mother was feeling the same feelings that this man that was dying, and it went through, and my mother literally, physically, completely changed. She don't look the same. She don't look the same. Ella no se miraba, ella cambió de una manera tan rápida, físicamente. Su voz era de hombre, no era de mujer, no era femenina. Her voice, it wasn't a masculine voice, I mean a female voice, it was a masculine voice. And then my father took the power, and then my mother began to just describe point by point. Empezó a mi mamá a decir punto por punto lo que tenía este señor. La maldición que le hicieron. que le hicieron y dónde estaba la maldición, y que tenía que ir debajo de esta casa donde habían ciertos huesos, y ahí le habían hecho una maldición. Spooky, eh? What happened that the spirit of God to my mother and the way that she changed personality. I'm not talking about a schizophrenic. I'm talking about a human being changed with a voice, a masculine voice, telling exactly point by point, this is your problem there below your house. There's so many bones. There's a curse that they have given you. And that's the reason you're going to die. What you had to do in this moment, he grabbed this man, and something happened that this little frog, we saw it, frog began to fly and hit the wall and fall down dead. It was so unbelievable. We were shaking, my brother was shaking. We have nightmare. We used to sleep together, we three used to sleep together, and we were scared. There was not a fear over the house. You can feel the demon, you can feel it. You can feel the manifestations of the demons and hell. My family was trapped. We was trapped. We were following a curse. We was under the curse. This is what my grandfather chose. This is what my father chose. And this is what my mother been so young believed. And there she got trapped literally. And it was hell. And there was all kinds of things that took place. Places that I never forget. And I, those things make a tremendous impression. The abuse of my mother, the physical, that didn't hurt, or even my father, that didn't hurt. I was immune to the physical pain. That doesn't hurt me anymore. But when my mother did something, it was verbally. Hay palabras que tú dices verbalmente que hieren completamente al ser humano para siempre. No era lo físico en la vida mía. Los castigos físicos, yo no sentía ningún dolor. Ya no sentía nada. Ni la sangre, no sentía nada. Pero lo más que me dolió y me destruyó psicológicamente y emocionalmente fueron las palabras de mi mamá. Se grabaron dentro de mi mente. Fueron las palabras de ella que me persiguieron en las calles de Nueva York. Fueron las palabras que ella no me quería cuando yo iba a cometer suicidio. ¿Cuántas veces yo pensaba quitarme la vida? How many times I really came to the place in my life to take my life away? But I was with the gang. I was a savage. Era un salvaje. When I was in my little room, I was the most lonely young kid that you ever see. Loneliness used to come like a seductive lady, grow inside of me, press on, hurt me so much, castigate me, took advantage of me. La brutalidad de la soledad fue lo peor que yo sufrí en las calles. Me mató. Me deprimía. Depressed me. Los recuerdos. Como es el diablo. How is the devil? My memories. There was damage completely. What? All the things that I saw since I was a child, all the things that happened to me. And let me tell you something, the one who paid the price was society. The only way that I can survive, it was to join a family, a gang, protection. That's the only way I can make it. But many times when I was, I couldn't sleep. I used to sleep about 1 or 2 hours. I could not close my eyes. When I used to be with the gangs, I changed. I became the worst of the worst. When I retreat to my little place, that little room, it was just 4 walls, a little bed, and there was a little table and 2 chairs, and there was a mirror that I had to look every morning or every night. And here, brushing my teeth, there I see the face of my mother changing so rapidly and became the face of the devil. And I was hunting with all these things. A lot of people say, from where you get this power? From where do you really, but why you so strong and you are not tall? But there's something in you, your heart. My heart was completely, completely hard. Corazón estaba duro, durísimo. Y lo que yo hice, I'm ashamed, what I did. Me siento avergonzado. The things that I always want to remember was the shame and the guilt and the loneliness. And I know many of you feel the same thing like I did. Some of you began to believe, I don't know why, that you have been cursed. You walk in the streets, these guys give all kinds of tracks or whatever, and here you can feel, tú puedes sentir lo diabólico, como el infierno se está quemando la gente, como el infierno está tomando la gente, como la gente está perdiendo la mente, se están volviendo locos y locas, estamos perdiendo nuestros hijos, we are losing our children, they don't live too long anymore, drugs is all over the corner, fighting between projects and projects, life is cheap. And that's the way I used to think. La vida era barata. No había ninguna forma de cómo uno poder vivir así. Ni la cárcel entrando y saliendo no me pudieron cambiar. Fumándome la mente en la cárcel, haciéndome preguntas a las 3 de la madrugada, fumándome un cigarrillo tras cigarrillo. Ahí está una voz dentro de mí. Me estoy hablando y no estoy loco. NIcky, si tú eres un ser humano, ¿por qué te conduces como un animal? NIcky, if you are a human being, why are you behaving like an animal? You trap. NIcky, si eres un animal, ¿por qué estás atrapado dentro de un ser humano? Dentro de tu cuerpo. If you are an animal, what are you doing trapped in a human being body? I was dying. I was like a demon-possessed man in the Bible that was coming out screaming from the cemetery, and the people used to be scared of him. He used to go ahead with voices screaming, touching himself with rock, screaming. And the people didn't understand that this man was sending a message to the whole community. What that man was telling that community, it was this: I'm dying, I'm burning, I need help. Help me, please. Me estoy muriendo. Estoy completamente ido de la mente. Necesito ayuda. Ayúdame. Ese era el grito que estaba diciéndole a la comunidad. Help me. you know, took the life of a friend of mine. I died in my arms in a rumble, in a fight. And it wasn't pretty. Eso no era bonito, esa escena. Cuando yo era niño, yo juré que yo jamás iba a llorar y jamás iba a amar. El amor no existía. Eso para mí no existía. Y me crié solo en Nueva York. Y yo más recuerdo en esos tiempos que estaba bien atrapado. Nadie podía entender la situación y nadie podía entender lo que me estaba pasando. But I was burning. I was trapped. I need help. But I don't know how. Yo quiero cambiar, yo estoy atrapado. Necesito ayuda, pero no sé cómo. Quiero cambiar, pero no tengo poder. I don't have no power to change. All this neighborhood stink. Those big rats. You remember the big rats in New York?
Yep.
Those big rats chasing the cat. Mira, los gatos miraban y decían, aquí salgo corriendo. Mira qué grande está esa rata. Los gatos le tenían miedo a las ratas. Lo que decía, huye el diablo, huye. And you know what? God is good.
Amen.
I didn't know anything. I watched my friend die, and there's nothing I can do for him. I was 18, he was 17. The only thing I saw was his blood coming from his chest, and I ripped off his leather jacket. And I know that he's gonna die. Blood was running like a fountain. And he was searching the sky. He was searching my face. And I'm looking at him and embracing him. I didn't know what to say. But I knew he was gonna die. Yo sabía que iba a morir. Y esa sangre es como rosa. Era tan fuerte como fuente que salía del pecho de él. Decíamos tantas cosas locas, pero no, yo no podía decirle te amo como amigo, como cantó Ismael. Tú eres mi pana. Now you're going. I looked in and searched in the sky, it was so gray. Estaba gris. No podía decirle a él la palabra que se merecía. Porque él era bien cerca a mí. Era, he was so close to me. And I could not tell him I love you. I want to cry, but I could not push my belly. I tried to torture myself to cry, but I could not put no tear from the well of my soul, from the well of my body. I just wanted to drop those tears on his face so he can feel how I felt. Yo quería esas lágrimas cayeran en la cara para que yo sintiera que yo tenía sentimiento. I do have feelings. But I didn't know, yo no sabía cómo decirle te amo mi amigo, como cantó Ismael. And I went crazy. But I thank God and I'm gonna just sum it up. I really thank God for David Wilkerson. He's in heaven. What he left, his heart, in my heart of evangelism, in loving people, reaching out to people. He was the man who had the courage to work courage. entrar a la zona de guerra y traerle ese mensaje como lo necesitaba el demoniado cuando se confrontó con Jesús y Jesús lo cambió. They were missing, he didn't come to condemn me. He didn't come over here with a message that so many preachers preach. They forgot about the pains of the people. They forgot one time that was in pain. Wilkerson didn't come over here to come and tell me that I'm going to go to hell. I already was in hell. Nobody had to tell me what hell is all about in the earth. Nadie tenía que decirme del infierno. Yo estaba en el infierno. Wilkerson no vino con ningún mensaje que tú te vas al infierno. Yo estaba en el infierno. Pero déjame decir una cosa de Jesucristo. Jesús te ama tanto que si Él tiene que ir al infierno para sacarte, Él te va a sacar. I might sound emotional. It's just flashing back. Standing here with Jesus alone, holding this microphone to tell you about the beauty and the goodness, about His grace, about His forgiveness. Oh, how the Holy Spirit got a hold of this man, David Wilkerson. Como el Espíritu Santo agarró, tomó a este hombre del campo, un campesino. He was a hillbilly. And he put his spirit, sent him to New York to be killed. There's no guarantee that he's going to get out. No había ninguna garantía que David Wilkerson iba a salir de esa zona de guerra. Porque todos estábamos unos salvajes. Dios no estaba en ninguno de los recuerdos de nosotros. And here is the message. NIcKy, Jesus loves you. Yes. NIcKy, Cristo te ama. Ese es el mensaje. Esa es la nota. Ese es el verdadero. El amor de Dios en darnos Jesús. Y yo me quedo mirándolo. Este sí está ido. Este se fue. Él estaba temblando, he was shaking. David was nervous. There was about 300 people around. Sure, I got the courage to embarrass him, to humiliate him, to push him, to spit at his face and call him all kinds of names. And then he came with this word, Jesus love you. And then he got bold. Se puso fuerte. He hit me in front of my face. I saw that change. He was shaking and now he changed. El temblando enfrente de mí cambió como la gente cambia a veces. Esquizofrenia. Se le cambió. Tú no le dices a un pandillero, mátame. David Wilkerson, you don't tell it. Again, they're right there with a gun and all this thing, kill me. And look what these guys say. Under the power of the Holy Spirit, that has to be. He had to be sent by God. He knew the consequences. Él sabía las consecuencias. Y así como estaba, ese hombre ha cambiado de una manera tan fuerte y vi una fuerza que lo tomó y su voz empezó a hablar recio, fuerte, y esa voz era con poder. Mátame, cierto, te hace sentir bien delante de esta gente y dice que make you feel good, kill me, kill me, do it. If that's going to make you feel good in front of them, do it. And I say, what's the matter with this guy? ¿Qué le pasa a este tipo? Otra. que tú no mates su espacio. Or not like that. Kill me. Hágame. Tú me puedes matar. You can kill me and cut me in 1,000 pieces. You can throw it right there on the street. Tú me puedes matar y cortarme en 1,000 pedazos. Pero recuerda una cosa, Nicky, de cada pedacito se levantará y te gritará que Cristo te ama y yo te amo, Nicky. That was the message. Oh. Hey, Nicky. You cannot kill love. Because God is love and He loves you.